In this video, I'm going to show you in less than 5 minutes how you can generate an Airtable project that fits your exact requirements using Airtable Cobuilder. Fun fact about this hack, I've shown it to many people this year, including Airtable consultants, and absolutely no one knew this was possible. And this hack is really a big time saver when you are starting an Airtable project. It will prevent you from having to create everything from scratch, and you will start with a boilerplate with mock data. Our process will be very simple. We will generate a prompt that will generate a prompt that we will paste in Airtable Cobuilder that will itself generate the database. Now, first, if we haven't met, my name's Alex. I'm one of the co-founders of 9x. We provide AI and automation trainings for business professionals. We teach you basics of AI all the way down to automations and AI agents. If you're interested in this topic, I recommend you subscribe to our YouTube channel. We are regularly posting and sharing tutorials, tool demos, and lots of other good stuff. So the starting point is this tutorial that is published on our website. Generate a database schema with AI. You can access it right here. You will have to leave your email if it's the first time you visit us. It is right here. And you're given an introduction. And we have basically three steps. The step one is to go to ChatGPT and copy the following prompt. So I'm going to press copy. I pasted the prompt in ChatGPT. Let's take a look at it. So role, you are a database schema expert. Task, you will help me create a prompt for Airtable Cobuilder that will help me create the schema of my dream app. Format, that's the secret sauce. You want to have a format where we're going to describe the tables, give the names of each field and their type. We give an example, so a contacts table with first name, last name, email, and a linked record would look like this. Some additional guidelines. You can refer to this article for an overview of the available fields. Only output the database scheme. No commentary at the beginning or at the end. And then we create a prompt for a, and this is where you have to specify what type of project you want to create. So let's try for an expense management solution. And you can see that tables and their fields are generated. So we have a suggestion, an expenses table, makes sense. A table with categories, one with payment methods. Not sure we're going to need that. Projects, approvers. And so we have that as a starting point. Now, at this point, you could go ahead and copy that prompt and paste it directly inside Airtable Cobuilder, and you will have a generated Airtable base and database schema. The whole point here is this is the step where you can configure, adjust your requirements, where you can specify exactly which fields, which field types for each of the tables inside your project. So that's the step where you're going to do some manual edits. And so for this, I'm going to head to Canvas and open Canvas to edit our database schema. Let's see. And this is open. And so I have my different tables. And here, this is where we're going to make the edit. So for instance, I don't think there should be a table payment method, and I'm going to remove that. I don't think there should be approvers, but rather it should be users. And so we're going to change that. Those of you who are familiar with Airtable will know what to write here. Basically, you know the field types. And if there's a field missing, all you have to do here is just write the name of the field, specify the type, and add it to your schema. Once we're done and we're happy with the suggestion here, we can copy that and head to Airtable Cobuilder. So we're inside Airtable Cobuilder. I'm gonna paste my prompt. We are ready to go, and I'm gonna click next. And it's going to first generate a preview of my app. And usually when you use Airtable Cobuilder, you just specify, I want an expense management app. And it's going to do that work of generating the field, making suggestions for us. But here, and this is the big difference, we have in our prompt indicated a database schema. And so what we have here matches exactly the specifications that we had in our database schema generated with ChatGPT. We can preview the result here. You can see that there's an expense table. We have categories. We had projects. we had users. If you remember, I had approvers. I didn't change the name of the approver name. So my mistake, but you can see this is matching exactly what we inputted. And that's going to give you that precision in order to generate projects fast. So once you're happy with that, we can create this app and wait a few seconds and we're going to see the result. Okay, we're back and now our app is right here. I can edit it. So one thing with Cobuilder, I'm still not very much using the interfaces generated because I have certain preferences when it comes to interfaces. The most important is the data section because that matches exactly what I need. We have exactly the fields specified by our prompt created. And what's more, we also have some mock data. And if you think about the time you would need to spend in order to create each table manually, or if you do even import of data, you would still spend a lot of time configuring the field types, adapting things, plus all the time you would spend generating fake data, going in ChatGPT and maybe generating fake project data and then doing the same for users and so on. That is all handled by Airtable Cobuilder, and you are ready to build. You are ready to develop your application further. What's left? Usually there are a lot of work. You will have automations to figure out because this is not generated by Airtable Cobuilder at the moment. I think it will be difficult also to get there. And interfaces, where usually there's a lot of interfaces that are generated. Maybe there's a few that are useful, but I tend to delete most of them and then restart from scratch. And that's already the end of this tutorial. As promised, short and sweet. Let me know if you found it useful. Let me know if you're using that hack in order to start your Airtable projects in no time. And I'll be back very soon with some more tutorials around Airtable and Airtable AI. So stay tuned. Cheers.